were German scholars who became known for their collections of fairy tales. They were born in the late 1700s near Frankfurt. The first volume of Grimm fairy tales appeared in 1812, the second in 1815, and the third in 1822. They were collected over a period of 13 years. The tales were popular because the brothers wrote them down just as they heard them so that they caught the spirit of the German people. Today, as part of our Christmas celebration, our cultural group presents one of their favorite fairy tales, The Elves and the Shoemaker. We have adapted the story for our group.
Once upon a time, there was a shoemaker who made shoes and he made them well. Yet luck was against him and he became poorer and poorer. Finally, all he had left was one piece of leather large enough for one pair of shoes. He cut out the leather for the last pair of shoes. After laying them in a neat row on his workbench, he said his prayers and went to bed. He said, "I'll get up early in the morning and finish the shoes." Early the next morning, the pieces of leather were gone. In their place stood a beautiful pair of shoes. He called his wife in, and she was just as surprised as he was. They looked for clues to figure out who had made the shoes, but didn't find any. So they put the shoes out for sale. Soon, a man came and bought them. Because they were so well made, the man was happy to pay more than the usual price. The shoemaker was able to buy enough leather and supplies for two pairs of shoes. As before, he cut the leather for the next day and placed them on the workbench and went to bed. In the morning, there were two pairs of shoes just as well made as the first set. Again, he sold the shoes for more than the usual price to a lady and a gentleman. And this time, he was able to buy enough leather for four pairs of shoes. Well, so it went on, night after night. He cut out the leather and laid it on his workbench. Morning after morning, there stood a row of handsome shoes, all kinds too. Shoes with laces, shoes with straps, shoes with high heels, and shoes that were flat, delicate slippers, and sturdy boots. Day after day, buyers came and paid such a good price that the shoemaker was able to buy more and more leather and sell more and more shoes, until at last he was poor no longer and became a well-to-do man. One evening, 2 days before Christmas, the shoemaker said to his wife, "Let's stay up tonight and see who has been so kind to us." They hid in a corner. They waited until just after midnight. A group of little elves squeezed through the slats of the shutters and sprang to the workbench and began making shoes. Zzz went the thread, tap, tap, tap went the hammers. How quickly they worked.
Thank you.
The shoemaker and his wife smiled at each other. They were pleased that their gift made the elves so happy. Thanks to the elves, the shoemaker now had many customers. He and his wife were never poor again. The shoemaker and his wife and the villagers celebrated a Merry Christmas.